Leonard Billicke here with an introduction to the new clause constraint system in Storm 0.6. The new constraint system allows to create complex constraints between and within meshes. In this example, we glued two meshes together and ripped them apart. Let's start with a new scene and create a simple plane by right-clicking in the Procedurals window and choosing the grid node. Increase the subdivisions for more resolution. Press T to create a transform node and rotate the grid by 90 degrees. Also move it a little to the right. By pressing Ctrl-C, Ctrl-V, we can duplicate the node. Let's change the values so we get another plane on the opposite side. The merge node merges the two planes into one stream. In the next step, we want to specify some points which are later controlled by the guide node. Create a set attribute node, set it to guide, the type to scalar, and the value to 1. Next, we use a little expression to limit the effect only on the top row of the points. At p.y greater or equal 5 will only write the guide value of 1 to the particles which position on the y-axis is higher or equal to 5, which is the top row of the plane. Now we can create a clause constraint node. There are two modes available, edges and points. Let's add a visualize constraint node to see what they are doing. Edges will turn all the edges of the mesh to constraints. Points will find other points in a given radius and create constraints between them. We will use the edge mode to hold the individual sheets of the cloth together. In the second step, we add another cloth constraints node and set it to point mode. But before we continue, we create different groups for the cloth sheets. So we go back to the top of the node tree and add a set attribute node on the individual streams of the planes. Set it to group and use a value of 1 in the first stream and a value of 2 in the other stream. Now we can go back to the second clause constraint node. As you can see, the node has different options on how to deal with groups. We can create constraints between different groups, within same groups, or on a specific group. We want the constraints to be created between different groups. Right now, the node is overwriting the constraints from the previous node. To fix this, we can set it to add constraints. Now the constraints of the two nodes are combined. Now we are ready to add the cloth solver node. We can prevent the edge constraints from breaking by disabling breakable in the constraint node options. Make sure create initial constraints is set to false. Otherwise, the node will again override the constraints. Also make sure that run procedurals on subframes in the general settings is set to true. To rip the sheets apart, we need to add a guide node. In a second undynamic stream, we create an animation of the two planes moving apart from each other. We can simply animate it by using a little expression. Just type the number of the frame, colon, and the value we want to set at this frame. So at frame 0 we want a value of 1 and on frame 100 a value of 100. Now the planes are animated. To better see what will be happening to our constraints during simulation, we can move the visualize constraint node to the end of the chain. Make sure you also add an end dynamics node. The visualize constraint node can display edges and point constraints. Since we are only interested in the point constraints, we turn off the edge constraints. Next, we weaken the point constraints between the sheets by changing break stretch to a lower value. This is a multiplier of the constraint break stretch value in the solver. As a last step, we increase the strength of the guide node and start simulation. As you can see, strange things are happening, but we can fix this easily. The guide node uses not only the position, but also the velocity of the guide mesh. By default, the transform node calculates the velocity from the transformation. In this example, we want to turn that off. And there you have it. Two sheets of cloth glued together and ripped apart in Storm 0.6.